The purpose of this video is to introduce some of the basic features of the PianoMeter app. As you can see, there are various indicators showing the pitch of a note. In the center, you have a numerical readout of the pitch in cents. The dial above also displays this information. Behind the dial, you have multiple strobe wheels that spin based on how sharp or flat a note is. The strobe spins counterclockwise if the note is flat, or clockwise if the note is sharp. When the note is in tune, the strobe stops. Depending on which note is being played, there may be multiple strobe wheels, each one for a different harmonic that is present in the complex tone of a piano. By default, the app will automatically detect and switch to whichever note is being played. However, in some cases, you may want to change the note detection mode. This is done with the slider on the left. In auto or jump mode, the app will detect and jump to any note anywhere on the piano. In stepwise mode, the app will only make small chromatic steps to notes that are close to the current note, but won't make large jumps. Lock mode prevents the app from switching notes altogether. In any of the modes, you can change the note by touching the desired note on the keyboard at the bottom of the screen. There are also hidden buttons to the right and left of the center indicator that let you step the note up and down by half steps or by octaves. These buttons are always active but remain invisible until you actually use them. At the bottom of the screen, there is a graphing area that shows the tuning curve that the app has calculated for your piano, as well as small dots representing the measured pitch of each note. On this graph, you can imagine equal temperament as a horizontal line through the middle of the graph. The vertical scale of the graph ranges from negative 50 to plus 50 cents, and you can see the upper notes of the piano are stretched sharp of equal temperament and the lower notes are stretched flat, which is what you would expect for a typical piano tuning. By swiping to the left or right, you reveal two other graphs. On the left, you have a frequency spectrum graph that shows the acoustic power for all the frequencies over the range of the piano. For example, if I play A2, I would expect to see multiple peaks in the spectrum, one for each harmonic of A2. There should be a peak at 110 Hz, another at 220 Hz, another at 330 Hz, another at 440 Hz, and so on up the harmonic series for A2. The relative strength of each harmonic is what determines the timbre or tone quality of a note. In the low bass, you'll notice that the lowest harmonics are often weak or missing. This is normal. Swiping to the right reveals the inharmonicity graph. Each dot on this graph represents the inharmonicity of one note on the piano, and the line represents a best fit that can be used to interpolate the inharmonicity for notes that haven't been measured yet. Typically, the inharmonicity is lowest in the tenor region, where the strings are long but aren't as thick as the strings in the low bass. The inharmonicity is greatest in the high treble, where the string stiffness to length ratio is large. Let's create a new tuning file. You do this from the main menu, which you open with the button in the upper left corner of the screen. Just for fun, let's name this tuning file. By default, the app starts with a generic tuning curve. This will change dramatically as we start to measure inharmonicity. At the beginning of a new tuning, it's important to sample the inharmonicity across the range of the piano to generate an appropriate tuning curve. The more notes you sample, the more accurate the tuning curve will be. The app will continuously measure and refine the tuning curve unless you lock the tuning curve using the button on the right. This prevents the app from measuring any new inharmonicity data. I'll often lock the tuning after performing the pitch raise on the piano and before beginning the fine tuning, but if you want to lock it after sampling only 6 notes, that's okay too. But it doesn't take that long to sample all the notes on the piano, minus the high treble where the higher harmonics aren't strong enough to measure inharmonicity. That should be enough to get you started. I'll be covering more advanced features like pitch raises, calibration, tuning file management, and temperaments in a separate video.